Hey everybody, it's Dean back with another episode of Factorio Megabase version 2. So, this last episode we were creating some more solar. Eventually I'll probably move this whole build down this way. We're doing other things like building out this red circuit build. It had been just two rows of assemblers. So we basically duplicated this row and just put it out. It's probably better to see it from this point of view. This view row was just put up here. I didn't really calculate ratios. I'm sure it's good. It's Sunday afternoon, early evening. Kids are outside playing, so we're gonna continue to hear them. It's just I'm not gonna mute them every time they come by unless they're literally right outside and you can kind of, I don't know. Not planning on muting them a whole lot, so unfortunately that'll be in the recording. So where are we headed? We are working towards yellow science. We got purple science flowing. We ripped up the previous purple science build. We only have the yellow science build and military science left in the base. Probably not going to do a whole lot more military science. I'm not planning on doing a whole lot more productivity, mining productivity. Right now I'm at 300%, bonus of 200% actually, and the original 100%, so 300%. So every mine's like three times its value. So, you know, 5 million is a 15 million, and they just take a while to mine out. If you go up to like my last mega base, I got, you know, like 1300%. They never mined out, and I could never build anywhere. I mean, I could, but it was just like I literally had to continually build over ore patches because they would never mine out. That's a good thing and a bad thing. Right now, I'm not wanting. I mean, I'm wanting these patches to disappear. So where are we? What are we doing? Really talked about last time about blue chips, you know, takes 20 green chips, but it takes 10 seconds to make one blue chip and it takes half a second to make one green chip. So in that 10 seconds, you make 20 of them. So I thought about, you know, okay, well, let's make, as I was doing with several of my other builds, you know, brick flows directly into electric furnaces, and electric furnaces flowing directly into purple science. It's a little harder to tell since we got this mine right in between, like I said, trying to get some things mined out. Eventually you'll just see a straight track through. I line this up so it would be like eventually just flow right in. So that's what I plan on doing. I plan on putting some right here. We are gonna do blue chips. Right below them we do some green chips, and then probably gonna do some copper and iron smelting. The disadvantage of, I mean, gosh, this ratio is just gorgeously beautiful, but to make one green chip's half a second, right, takes one iron plate and 1.5 copper plate. Well, to make one iron plate takes 3.5 seconds. So you're gonna need like 7 times the smelters. Technically, if they're the productivity modules and everything, the speed modules and all were exactly the same. So this area down here will pretty much be, you know, big builds of copper and iron. I mean, I'm sorry, yeah, copper and iron. So we're gonna have basically a couple big builds, copper, iron down here, and then we'll have probably say 3, maybe 4 blue chip builds across the top with the equal number of green chip builds directly below them, being directly fed by the smelters below them. And of course I'd love to be able to get this ore. So, I mean, it's just some beautiful patches, especially there's the 11 million one right there. You know, it just means the trains have to travel less to get there. Eventually, though, we're going to have to dig deep into this territory to pull ore out to feed it. We're going to have a couple things like that. We'll probably have a southern feed route to feed the rest of the southern, this area up here. And or, you know, northern. We shall see, we shall see. For now, though, I want to kind of start building out some of this. It's going to be kind of just landfills. Probably this oil. I definitely want to be oil. We have petroleum gas build that needs oil, which feeds our sulfuric acid, which feeds our blue chips. So we definitely need the oil. We have another oil up here. So honestly, I've already built the second petroleum gas build, and it's only being fed by one oil train. So we probably ought to do this build here. It's really hard to tell how many of those are, but it's roughly 20 pumps. So let's just give ourselves 20 pump janks. And then need some tanks, some pumps. Alright, so it gave us 20 pump janks. Let's grab 4 tanker cars. Okay. You know what? Let's make 2 trains out of that. I think technically both of those stations could be 2 trains, though. The first one was not designed with 2 trains in mind. We'll just go here for the pumps and tanks. Seems like we got a bunch of extra junk here. Let's drop off some. Create some room in our pockets. Now we're going to grab some more underground pipes. We'll grab them stacks of 50 and they can come out of storage. It's probably definitely plenty. Do the same with track. Get rid of the stack of 19, but grab 100. So we're headed to here, but technically, do I want to build off of this track? Could. Even initially could. Probably ultimately, let's see, where is the petroleum gas build? It's off here. Start by coming in here, I guess. Yeah, we'll do this one. We have a stop here, northeast 15, so we'll go there. Yes, I am forgetting stuff. Speed modules and beacons. grab. And away we go. So we're, I guess now we got an iron train coming in. I was thinking for a second we might have been kind of a little shy on iron, but we worked on that a couple episodes ago, but we do have iron running out in at least two builds. We did move, this was like four trains. We did, or five trains actually, and we moved three of them to here. I think this was 8 million something when I first built it. It's already down to 7.7, so. Alright, well, we're here. How are we going to build this? This looks like some water. Actually, I don't have room for that, do I? And we can start by putting out the pump jacks. Just have to hold down left click. And when it fits, it will go in. Rotate them after we get them in. Is that it? Oh, I should have brought water. I think probably handcraft 3. Yep. So we'll do that. So we have 23 of them. Now that's roughly 6 per tanker car. So we want, how do we want to load this? Probably want to use as minimal space as possible. So we'll load it right there. Where are our other oil belts? Got this one. Now we want the tanks on the right side. We have another oil belt here that's still on the same side. This is one we can use. Room for beacons. And secondly, we want, we can put these guys in. Let's get the actual station. Not exactly how long that needs to be. Some power. Gonna need a radar in there too. Just get there for now. Gonna want some kind of stacker in this. Can fill in some patches of water. We got tons of water. And actually in this area we're not gonna need water. So we'll I guess we could fill that in too. Not a fan of filling in water, but fan of having a million like spots too. stacker lanes, don't need it. We don't have three drains, we'll just have two. If we need two, we can look at our train depot to see how long this really needs to be. Since it's a bi-directional track, you don't want rail signals on it, otherwise the train can get stuck. Let's get our train up there so we're stop blocking traffic. Whoa. Thought I got in the front of it. Whoa, dude. Chill. Suppose we should have brought some train fuel. All these things are blinking. Alright, so I said six per row of these guys. That one will actually be five. And the ones in the middle are always the kind of like the high output ones. Just kind of like regular ore patches, the stuff in the middle is always the highest. So like this one looks like the highest at 41.6. 41 per second at productivity 300%. It's like 120. I think that thing alone probably could fill all these tanks to start with. But they do deplete slowly. Like this one's been doing the petroleum gas, and it was like 4,500, now it's down to 3,000. That's another reason to add more oil outposts. They do deplete, and eventually, I mean, which is crazy though, is I've got three builds like that. Now they're like 470, 350, and I forget the third spot. That feeds the main base. You know, but with massive beacons on it, even at 2 per second, they still do pretty well. These tanks are full, so I got three of these feeding the main base, and they've been defined the whole game. Kind of once we stop going to the main base, well, I could probably redirect those. So I guess maybe these five will be, say this one, six, this, this. Neat thing about these pump jack builds, they're always like little puzzles. Over this way. So that's 6, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 6. These two ought to be kind of linked together, so I don't know. So that's 6. And then these guys. And that's that. And we need the beacons. This part. It's pretty much anywhere they touch 2, I'm happy with. Of course, if they touch more than 2, I'm more than happy with. Those two aren't gonna get much, are they? Sometimes they're close enough, like in this case. that. Get a little extra help. Oh my goodness. Sorry I had to mute that, but oh my goodness, it gets a little reading lunatic out there. Seeing the number of beacons you can get around these. Don't see any more likelihoods. Keep looking here. Of course, you can do ones, but you might as well just put speed modules in the pump at that point. Section, we could do another one. It's okay. Good, let's get in some modules. these two have so little love, I'm gonna actually give them modules as well. Then we can give these guys power. I like using these guys. Substations, they were great. What was I connected to? Should be connected to everything. Oh, why it's not? That's where I connected it. Well, it's got it out. All right, so this is going to be oil 5-ish. First assignment. I'm gonna copy you, set you on automatic. Get you another one. to. And we got a train going by outside too. So that's going to support. So this comes up to here, and the dead end's right there. That's why I'm getting a new path. And it's fine for these trains, they don't need to come to the main base. But, for my guy, I suppose I can just drive out the track. And then go. We need this bit here anymore. There was probably a station right there before I built all this up. So, all I do is just add a couple more trains to the station. Fuel at each drop off. So when those guys pull in, they can get fueled up. Technically, we could probably do that to this guy. Some big coal mines. Okay, so if we do this, blue chips here, green chips here. So we can start off with just one build of each. So we do the first one here. I know it's a little further away than everything, but there's more ore here. I don't care about the uranium. I'm not doing nuclear. And I got plenty of it. Absolutely plenty of it. It's one thing I'm not a big fan about the uranium pet, or the builder map thing. It's just there's always so much of it. 9 million. Like, that's just horrid. Patches should be like 200k or something, 300k. It should be 1/10 of what they are. mods here. But there are construction mods. Not enough storage. It's not gonna get built. Just standing there. We're roughly going the same location. Northeast 25 east. I do want to make sure we have enough track. Bear. Builds don't need to be terribly complex. I mean, 20 green chips per blue chip, like, will eat up a train pretty fast of green chips. Though the advantage of having the green chip train, like, right there is gonna help. I do want to mine up this guy, like, pronto. Signals in here. Radars would be nice. So how big are these builds? That's the kind of question of the day right now. Can use some stone bridge. Sufficient. And then I guess the real question is, do I run up? I mean, there should be a stacker of some kind, right? I mean, there's going to be sulfuric acid and the blue chip trains coming in minimally. So maybe the track I just ran is not exactly how we should say going. We are working towards yellow science on the Megabase scale of things. I've reserved kind of this whole section for blue chips. The blue chip build. It's going to be one outpost into another. So like we're doing brick into electric furnaces. They don't actually get off the main. They don't enter the main track. They just go from one build to the next, and then electric furnaces are going straight into purple science. So we are going to do blue chips directly fed by green chips because it's an exact 20-to-1 ratio. So at the minimum we're going to do that, and then it's going to take quite a bit of smelting to feed each green chip build. Because it's iron plate is 3.5 seconds to make one, where it's 0.5 second to make a green circuit. So it's seven times. You need seven times the iron plate smelters to make one green chip if you're going to do it every 0.5 second. So that is the kind of conundrum here. The reason why it's going to take so much space is just the smelting, I think. Literally, it's going to take, I mean, if we do three builds, I don't think we're going to be able to do three builds, probably two. But if we can do it in raw and blue out. Basically, I mean, down here, raw will be coming in. Sulfuric acid bringing in from outside, and red chips bringing in from outside, but they're right here. So we will be feeding those directly in. Sort of, we will need to probably get this track in. I haven't thought about that a whole lot right now, but it is part of the thinking. And I just was thinking about how am I setting up these blue chips line area. One, it's going to be a whole ton of landfill. Wondering if I should convert that to landfill or just use my current landfill build. So my current first Megabase blue chip build looked like this. It's just two rows of assemblers with pipe. So it's sort of a ugly-ish build. But the I combine blue and battery build and truck in petroleum, copper, iron, and water for the yellow signs. Because you don't need batteries for blue chips, I don't think. I got my sulfuric acid built, so this is ready to go. We just need access to it. So we're going to need, of course, the sulfuric acid for both blue chips and batteries. Battery build's probably going up here somewhere. Space science. I'm going to guess it's going to be in this area, which is going to require a whole massive amount of landfill. And I already knew this was the landfill board. Okay. I'm not a big fan of filling in lakes, but it's just the way it's going to be. Let's run down here and make a landfill build. Alright, and then we do have a sort of a landfill build already, so we're gonna copy some of that. I don't think we need to go as crazy about it. But we can copy some of it. previous build. I'm not using it anymore on it, but I'm gonna use it here. Like to chew up stones. Personally think ones that are damaged, the game has to think about all the time. The ones that aren't probably are not. It's just a personal guess of mine, but I don't really know. I'm trying to decide how to do a stacker. Guess trains come in here. Stacker. So kind of permit. That's the red chip train also to access all this, so we'll... It's not a bad idea. Wondering how I was going to connect this. I thought I'd bring it down and then over, but we kind of go up at an angle here or curve up. Angled tracks are doable, of course, but yeah. Right, I have another thought. All right. Doing the whole angle track thing. Just build up to this other track, and then they both split off this way. One, that way I don't waste a whole section up this way. Kind of thinking I should. Let's signal this. Power poles. reason I did that, because when I build this next piece, I wanted it to fit. So right here. So, we can do this now. I'm gonna have a lot more room. Our landfill's a little further away. We can also do our stacker right here. Which I think right there. Technically, it's one sulfuric acid train per build, and one, say, red circuit train. That's probably plenty. Do the four-way split thingy. Out of track. section of track we can pull up. Actually, I need to get rid of some trash. I do have a bunch of track in there, don't I? Pull that out before I forget about it. I'm gonna need those lasers right now. Ore miners. Probably done with the balancer, probably done with the router track. Right now it can be done with landfill. I've hardly got any neat thing about landfill is you can pretty much get rid of stone real fast. So the first build, assuming we do everything normal, this is right, chips coming in on the top, sulfuric acid on the top, and then green circuits on the bottom, and red circuits on the bottom. If I want to change that, I mean, it would be mean rerouting, redoing some of my build, but I already was gonna do redo some of it. In fact, let's sort of build this in the clear to start with. So, one of the things that's possible is building a whole nother row of this. One is I want to flip this row around. somebody once mentioned I should do my chest closer to the roboport, so that totally makes sense. I definitely do a bigger build. Problem is routing all the sulfuric acid. Set those down by one. They're perfectly lined up with the other beacons. You know what? Let's just copy this whole. How are these off by one? So hard to do this. The only way I can seem to do this is because I don't have enough beacons on me. Take that, rotate it, and set it. And I think that's a better. See, these cover all the chests. Tough thing will be supplying the sulfuric acid now. guys won't be like this. Question I did have was, should I put the pickup train and drop off the red circuits on the top and only have the green circuits come in from the bottom, since it's going to be direct insert, or, you know, just permit the red circuits to come in and out kind of here. Ripping this whole thing up, or at least chests and track. Track. So this would be green circuits in the middle. Get all those on the same side of the track. Starfighter chess. So fighter chests are going to be on both middle one and one of the sides. The requester chest being on the one of the sides, since it's in there. We don't want, though they do have communication wire on them. Let's leave those. Do this have track on it? Yes, that's why it's not lining up. Track only lets you line up by two spaces. You need to do it by one to get it to work. Technically speaking, I don't need all this wire going here. But we'll leave it alone for now. I mean, because one set of power poles would supply both sides, right? Let's actually do that. Side. Must be perfectly lined up. Now you do want, because we do want these guys in here. You need to be able to read the signal. Cursor. So if I want to read the signal, which I probably will for at least the red circuits, And the sulfuric acid, which we haven't done yet. Then we can. Don't completely build this, but... get these to line up on both sides. So when these are tiled, if necessary, they all talk to each other. Somewhere in here we have do it right next to that one. So we need to do it next to the requester chest. We need a two arithmetics. From the rubble part, and it feeds into the other one, which goes to a power pole, and we need a requester chest. I can't connect that to a ghost, I don't think. So this will just chain, take anything that's, I mean, everything that's coming in and turn it into, we're only interested in blue chips. So we only add zero. So we get the accurate count and output blue chips. And then this will be each of the chests added together. And then this will output blue chips. So I'll take all the requester chests and this one, add it together and put it out on. Though we're going to need this station one. We are also going to want a counts a combinator. And we're gonna name this M. And we're gonna put it at 64,000. Red chips, we did 128,000, I think. 128,000. But blue chips only stack to 100. So each train holds only 16,000 versus 32,000 on the other two circuits. Oh, and we need to connect that on the green wire. So all these power poles now have that value. Do we want to do the other circuits? So for instance, if substation. Really don't need one, just need one more power pole on this. So if in this case 1 is greater than or equal to 'cause M is typically what I use for how much goes on a train. You know what, let's do how much goes on a train with a train symbol. I'll put an E. And then, actually, let's not use a train symbol, let's use a railroad car. And we shall set that at 16,000. So, train and railroad cars. One is greater than railroad cars, full load. Oh, pretty. That's going to attach to there. We're going to get the one from the power pole. We're also going to have to get the green from that power pole, which is the railroad car value. And then we will enable this station if greater than 0. Oh crud. So use the center one to be the pickup train. This is wrong. Not to pick a train. This down here is a pickup train. We need to connect that one to both the green and red to the power pole. This will be that. This will be, in this case, green chips. And this will be a reading from the robot port, actually. Which we don't have access to at the moment. How many green chips are in supply? When this is less than 0. Actually, yeah, we want that to be green chips. Less or equal to say 2,000. We'll enable the station. Same thing, greater than 0. I allow a green train to flow in. If we want to do it that way, one of the things I talked about is have two trains from each green chip station. And one would be in one bay and one would be in the other with a, you know, a passing lane between them. And then when you wouldn't need these. I'll leave that for the moment just so I can blueprint this. Kind of wish I'd done this up there. Of course I can. This is relatively done. That's my blue chip build. I'm gonna stick in my game blueprints. This was my mid-game loop trip build. This is the 242 blue chip. Substations got put in. I didn't have any of the regular ones. Okay, all that. We have two of these, right? I mean, we're gonna have this way to describe this. We have one of these. Flow over this way. Signals won't be right, but I'm gonna get this out towards the middle. In fact, this stacker and all that should be probably redone if I want all this stuff close as possible to the where the builds will be. So on that note, Center off center. It's right here. It's more of the likely spot for the stacker and all that. Second one. This is still not a 100% build. Be like this one. So your gas would be in something like this. Low track coming in. So us that can make an angle like that. I'm gonna have to split that there though. This guy's exit train. Oops. It won't be petroleum gas, it'll be sulfuric acid. So I have both. We probably should have an exit lane. I was thinking this was just going to be red chips, but it's not going to be. It's going to be red chips and... blue chips. Space roughly in the middle. I think that's the build. Signals in there. chips. Could have probably now put this a little closer. You ought to split three different ways. Two tanks, three different ways. Really not that. Alright, we got three exits of this tanks. Track is making it a little difficult. Well, that really is going to help. Bill not have any pipes in it? Nope, it does not. Well, unfortunately, we can make some, but it's not going to be nearly enough. I'm just trying to get some so I can do this build, and... You know what? Let's disable my bots. This one will go over here. This one will go to the top one. This side's gonna be a little easier. Sorry about the kids being really loud outside. Turn on the remote ports again. Connect. Guess I already did. Somewhere I didn't connect to the remote port. This guy. Technically doesn't need the green wire. Missing a few things, but I think it's looking fairly well. About 300 pipes. That's about it. I guess from this build right here, we'll put in the blue chip station. Fuel. needs a safe walk in the park to walk here. Suppose I could put those two stations right here in the middle. Basically, I could put question is how connected it into that. Certainly ugly. Sure why there was a signal here. Probably gonna want a longer train stop for the chip station. We'll be bringing long trains down. Don't really need you. Chess. Do I need any? Yes, I need like 14 of them. Well, let's make a couple of handfuls. Hopefully, let me keep a couple. Where do I want to stick that RoboPort? Stick it there. I don't have much choice about it. Bots in here. sulfuric acid. Turns out I didn't, you know, really need a ton for just handling iron plate, but I did forget. Oh, look at those. Let's make sure. Chests. So also need our pipes to finish the BD off. I do need a, I guess from this guy. Build some dummy stations. Sulfuric acid. Well, we haven't named these yet, have we? Alright, blue chip. Sulfuric acid. Unload. So when that gets disabled, and then we need blue chip. Red chip unload. This needs, well, let's paste that other one in there first. This one needs a circuit. Kind of like the green chips above. Let's just copy this one, change it to red chips. So we're getting the red chips from the RoboPort. Putting it on this, E greater than zero. If we're going to control these stations to only make up to 128,000 or whatever their M value is, then we also need to control the light. Haven't decided on doing that yet. This won't request anymore if there's already red chips in the station. Same with green chips. And blue chips will only enable if there's enough to load a train. Oh, we do need to change these to blue chips. Since they only stack to 100. Actually, 667, I think, was right. I think the red chip one was wrong. Well, still needs to be blue chips, but. here next to the red chip, so I'm gonna fix it. Wires, but that's probably some permanent track we can fix right now. Just give me some chips. So, red chips is 32,000 per train, which is 8,000 per car divided by 24. Is that real? What? Divided by 12, not 24. 667. I guess that's right. Okay, so I guess I'm used to doing only 6 chests for some loading stations. So 12. So these should really be 334 of them. That should be that. I still need the pipe. Let's turn it into the fuel train. The fuel train should go. Zero. And BC. Numbers or anything, because you know, whatever the green chip build is, I only have one spot I can get to. now. Do have some signals right here. Let's go there. I'm gonna finish that. We're not ready to work it yet. Actually, we're quite a ways from being able to work it. Myself the ability though, I believe. No, I didn't. The wrong train type. And we do have one sulfuric acid train we can bring over. Sulfuric acid train comes back. Let's suppose we have that build. Sulfuric acid as part of that blueprint. It might be just, you know, dependent on future builds. Should have petroleum gas flowing in. Mm-hmm. But that's momentary. Stops once it's at 200k. That way that train can feed other things than just one station. Well, next time we're gonna have to work on the green circuits for this. We'll probably put green circuits here. Do want a section of track, which will kind of be convenient for this guy. Though we might take this one kind of around so we can get at that. Blue chip build here. That'll feed directly into this, and then south of that we shall have iron and copper plate forging to feed the green circuit. And trying to gonna keep all the outposts self-contained. The less trains that are traveling around on the main track to supply, say, green circuits to blue circuits. I mean, there's so many train loads worth that, you know, we're just gonna save that kind of congestion to a dedicated build. Now we can just do one green circuit build for the blue circuit build, because it's a perfect ratio. It's the forging requirement is going to be something of a challenge, I think, because it's 7 iron plate forges ish. Quite got the numbers right on that, I'm sure, because level 3 assemblers can take 4 productivity modules, where the forges, electric furnaces, can only take 2. So the ratios are going to be off. Like, not only do you get more productivity for, actually, I don't think that part was going to matter. That part I don't think matters. Anyways, I didn't get much sleep last night, so I'm really tired. I'm having a hard time concentrating. I mean, we made a good start. Starts a start, the blue chips. We can kind of go it slow like the foraging setup and just kind of ramp up as needed. We shall see. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'm gonna call it on this one. If you have any questions, ask them in the comment section below. And if you'd like to see more, do follow me on Twitch or subscribe on YouTube. We'll see you later.